taking your time away from your busy schedules this morning to join us again for our Premier Life Weekly. Wanted to kind of discuss a little bit of what we've done in the past, this past couple weeks. We've uncovered some exciting and timely topics such as power of living benefits and the life insurance planning, life insurance sales opportunity in the business owner markets, and last week we discussed a very niche product concept in the business owner market called Section 79. So today I have with us, I have Mark Ryan, JD, of he's a director of advanced sales for the National Life Group, which is a parent company for Life of the Southwest, and we're going to be discussing some hot topics in business, estate planning, market called premium financing for life insurance. And yes, premium financing is back in the market. And Matt, can you explain to us a little bit here, why is premium financing so hot again for 2015?
Well, Kathy, there's a couple of reasons why premium financing has really come back on the radar screen. First is that these lending institutions, for the last several years, since the sort of the credit bubble burst back in 2008, was that lending and underwriting for lending have become very strict. And these lending institutions, they kept a lot of the capital on their books, so they weren't willing to lend that money. And just over the recent last 2 years or so, capital has become more available to those individuals looking for those lending relationships, and those banks and the underwriting of those lending institutions have become a little bit more liberal in terms of getting money out there to their customers. That coupled with the fact that bank rates, which are usually tied to either prime or LIBOR, have been creeping down. As a matter of fact, they're at all-time lows. So it makes borrowing very attractive for those individuals who understand lending and leverage. And this allows the client to obviously retain their capital and their assets and earn a good rate of return while borrowing money at a lower rate of return. With that said, the development of new products, innovative products like IUL, have made financing attractive as well because that product has an upside potential in the form of higher interest crediting rates that other products that were used back in the heyday of premium financing, such as universal life products, fixed products, or current assumption products, or whole life products, didn't offer. So you have the potential of upside risk as well. Also think that agents are looking to complement their existing book of business with this sort of strategy. But those individuals have to be cautious, I think, because premium financing is not a sales strategy. First and foremost, the individual client has to have that life insurance need. Once that life insurance need is sold to that particular client, then we look at ways, along with the agent, to look at how we're going to fund for that premium payment based upon that client's net worth and their asset makeup. And it might just be that that individual has a lot of assets tied up either in their business or with other investments that doesn't allow them to take that money out and invest that in a life insurance contract with respect to premium payments. So there's a lot of various reasons why it's hot, but those are just some of the, I think, the main points as to why premium financing has kind of made a little comeback here in the last year, 2 years from this point.
Wonderful. How exactly does premium financing work for your agents out there who have never done this? How do they...
Sure. So, premium financing is designed for wealthy individuals or business owners who understand the concept of borrowing someone else's money. Those clients, and I'm speaking in general, but I'll get more specific here with respect to what National Life Group looks for, but those individuals have to have a high net worth. And at National Life, we're looking for individuals that have a net worth of over $5 million. We're looking for individuals that have an income level that they can support through tax tax returns of over $100,000 annually. Someone that is sophisticated when it comes to understanding, obviously, leverage, interest rate risk, and collateral risk. I find that when I deal with a lot of clients and their agents, that sometimes they might understand the crediting risk. If you're an insurance agent, you sell life insurance, you probably understand that. But what most people often don't understand is that there is a collateral risk, a risk that the client is going to have to come out of their pocket with additional money if the policy doesn't perform based upon what it was illustrated at. Or something else happens. Or interest rates go up, the LIBOR rate goes up or prime rate goes up. Those are all risks that that high net worth individual will have to understand before he entertains a premium financing transaction. So it's important for the agent to understand those risks as well so they can have that discussion with the client. Now, at National Life Group, we have a team here that's a resource for you to help educate you and help train you with respect to that, to help speak with clients and their financial advisors and their tax advisors and legal advisors to explain the concepts like premium financing. So we're typically looking at a target market of an individual, $5 million or more net worth, who is very sophisticated when it comes to investments and understands leverage and using somebody else's money, who has an income level that's going to support that potentially could support the premium payment. We never want to have a case where an individual doesn't have the income level, but maybe had the high net worth, doesn't have the income level in order to pay for that premium payment out of his pocket if something would ever happen, or post additional collateral if something should ever happen either to the crediting rate of the policy or to interest rates of that loan. So we always want them to be prepared that they have to come out of their pocket at some point in time.
Okay, you kind of went over your the income that they're going to be looking at, the $5 million plus or $100,000 a year on this
sure.
the type of market. Can business owners, can you go into details on, so if an agent's actually out there looking for those type of clients, who they actually should be monitoring more, like your business owners, anybody else they should be looking at?
Sure, and I'll kind of just repeat myself, Kathy, but that in terms of whether or not premium financing is a strategy that you should be going out looking for, I don't necessarily subscribe to that belief. I subscribe to the belief is you should be looking and speaking with small business owners and servicing those needs and providing solutions to them. Life insurance is one of those solutions or could potentially be one of those solutions to those individuals. So whenever you're speaking with an individual that is a small business owner, somebody who has inherited wealth, okay, and they have over a $5 million net worth, all right, and they have a life insurance need, and for some reason, after you're speaking with that client, after they've understood the fact that they have a life insurance need, and they're finding and trying to beat themselves up with ways to how they're going to purchase that life insurance, how they're going to come up with the money for that life insurance, that is a point in time to take a look at potential premium financing as being a source for those premium dollars that are going to be going to that policy. And typically, those premium dollars don't last forever. Typically, those premium dollars last for anywhere between 5 to 10 years of how these cases are designed. And there's going to be some sort of exit strategy that the client is going to execute, and death is not an exit strategy. So it would be a sale of some assets. It would be, okay, at this point in time, they have enough assets, accumulated enough assets where they can start paying the premiums out of their pocket if the premiums went on for more than 10 years. So, again, it's not a strategy, I think, that you go look for actively in terms of who is a potential candidate for premium financing. I think anybody who has over a $5 million net worth, that's a high business owner, that has their assets tied up, that has sufficient income level, is potentially a candidate for premium financing if they're not able to afford the premium payments, or not, I shouldn't say afford, if they're not able or willing to, sell assets in order to support those premiums, or understand leverage and how leverage works with respect to paying those premiums and using somebody else's money.
Wonderful. So basically the clients, they're not going to know about this. This is something that each agent individually is going to have to do their own fact-finding to make sure they can actually understand what the client's needs could be and how to potentially, you know, show this to them in the future.
That's correct, Kathy, and that's your typical case. So I think it's incumbent upon the, you know, the financial advisors out there, the people who are selling financial products, including life insurance, that they go out, okay, when they're speaking with their clients, that they understand and know that premium financing potentially could be a solution for those individuals, high net worth individuals, that need life insurance, that have the assets to pay for those life insurance, but a lot of times small business owners have all their assets tied up in their business. And if they have a successful business and they've been growing it year over year and they're getting a return on their money of 20-30% in some cases on their money, why would they ever want to take that money out? Okay, or why would they not want to reinvest that money back in their company to earn that rate of return when they can go out and borrow somebody else's money, okay, at less than 4%, less than 5%, and purchase a life insurance contract and use those bank dollars in order to support those premium payments? To them, it makes sense because now they're able to make that 20-30% on their business, okay, and still purchase life insurance because they have a need for it.
Wonderful. So, Matt, I know when we first started talking a little bit and before that everybody else was on this webinar and stuff, just want to give us some information about what you actually do. I mean, you're the director of sales, advanced sales, but I'm sure you see a lot of these cases. But can you just give us a little bit of background on what you do and what you see with a company?
Sure. So what I do is, again, as Kathy described to you, I'm one of two directors of advanced sales here at National Life Group. The other one is Ellen Lamer. Okay, we also have two other advanced sales consultants, one David Hayward and the other Brian Pritchard. And what we do is we provide a resource for those financial advisors that are speaking with those small business owners, those high net worth individuals, to use as a resource to find solutions to those problems or those problems that those particular individuals have with respect to either business planning need or an estate planning need. So you can pick up the phone at any point in time and give us a call and bounce off your client's scenario and tell us what their needs are, and we can sort of put our heads together to see whether or not we can come up with a solution. Now, and that could be for some business planning purposes, buy, sell, keep personal life insurance, non-qualified planning purposes or qualified planning purposes, estate planning purposes, but it also could be for premium financing as well. So you can pick up the phone, you can call myself up, you can call Bridget Lackey, another advanced sales consultant, and we typically vet every single premium financing case. Okay, so if you have a potential client, we are the individuals to call if you're considering using National Life Group's IUL product or other products that are going to be used for premium financing. And so we will have the initial conversation with the agent to make sure that the agent has vetted the client thoroughly, that they understand what our guidelines are, they understand what the client's needs are in terms of the life insurance need, in terms of what the asset makeup of that particular client is, what the need of the life insurance is. And typically we see a lot of premium financing cases being used for life insurance policies that are going to be held in an irrevocable life insurance trust for estate planning purposes. All right. You know, when I say that we have a $5 million net worth, our typical client usually is not $5 million. Our typical client is $10 million and over. That's what I've been seeing for the last year and a half or so. It's not the clients that have a $5 million net worth, a $5.5 million net worth, but clients that have $15 million net worth, $15 million, in some cases $80 million, in other cases $1 billion net worth. So we see them well over the $5 million mark. And really, those are individuals who have accumulated a lot of wealth over the lifetime, who have inherited a lot of wealth over the lifetime, and have an estate planning need, and that's what they're purchasing life insurance for.
Wow. So basically, there's a lot of clients out there that really could use some help. The Edgar Center telling us, you know, 10, 15, 80 million and $1 billion clients. There's clients out there to help, you know, that you can go talk to and start working with, you know, clients in this direction.
Absolutely. I think that, you know, there are a lot of people over the last 5 or 6 years who, not a lot, you know, middle class people, but a lot of those people that were on the fringe of upper class, middle class, that did pretty well over the last 5 years or so. There's a lot of those individuals. A lot of those individuals, if you ask me, every single one of them, I think, needs life insurance protection for some reason or another, whether that's income replacement, whether that's, you know, for estate planning needs or business planning needs. Life insurance is a great vehicle that solves a lot of problems. It's not the only vehicle, but it's a great vehicle that solves a lot of those problems. And so when you're speaking with a client that has a need for that life insurance, again, you should be aware of the fact that once you've sold them that need, you know, I found, and I've been on the other side of things. I've sold life insurance, and, you know, it's almost like a two-step process, probably even more. But once you've sold that life insurance need, and then you got to ask for the money, okay? And sometimes they don't like coming out of pocket with a lot of these premium payments. And we're talking about premium payments, you know, over $100,000 annually in some of these cases. And just last week we closed one. It was $789,000 annual premium for 10 years. That's over $7 million of premium over the 10-year period. That's a big check for that client to cut. Okay?
Right.
So, you know, if that's why, you know, that individual knew how life insurance worked, knew how leverage worked, more importantly, and didn't want to use his own money. That coupled with the fact that it was going to be owned by irrevocable life insurance for estate planning purposes, then you have gifting issues. Okay, how do you get the $700,000 or $800,000 into that trust? Well, the annual exclusion is not going to be enough. Okay, in this particular case, the lifetime gift exemption. Okay, they could use that. Okay, do they want to use all of that? Do they want to use any of that at this point in time? Or do they want to wait? Well, in this particular case, they didn't want to use it right now. So how do you get that $700,000 in there without paying any gift tax? Well, you do it, okay? You don't have to pay the premium, but you pay the interest on that premium and that loan, okay, which is a lot less than $789,000 annually, all right? So if the interest payment on that loan is going to be somewhere in the vicinity of anywhere between $50,000 to $75,000, that individual can make a gift to that islet for $50,000 to $75,000 and potentially stay under, okay, have enough, you know, beneficiaries of that trust to stay under their annual exclusion or use less of their lifetime gift exemption at this point in time. So it's a great planning vehicle for those individuals that find themselves in that situation where they want to have to pay a lot of gift tax if they're doing some estate planning and having an islet purchase that life insurance contract.
You know, I like the fact that when the agents go out and they can actually do their fact-finding with their clients, they can actually call you guys, you know, so they're not alone. They can call and get some support and get some help, and you guys will help run the quotes. Now, do you talk to the clients on the phone with the agents, or how does that work?
We will talk with the client as long as the agent's on the line or other legal or tax advisors that are on the line. We'll certainly speak with them. We have the ability to show or perform the case design. We work very closely, remember, because this is not National Life Group's money, okay? So we work with other lenders, and typically you're not working with, we're not working with a direct lender. We're working with an intermediary. And when I say a direct lender, we're not working directly with a bank, okay, your local bank, who the client has gone to and says, they service my business loans, so I'll just go to them and borrow the money from them. Well, they typically don't understand the premium financing transaction that involves a life insurance contract because it is kind of unique. And there are a lot of moving parts, and there's a lot of things to understand that those banks won't understand about life insurance. So we typically work with organizations, lending organizations, that have the knowledge of how a premium financing of a life insurance contract works. And usually when we work with those individuals, they have intermediaries, okay? They're called intermediaries, where those are actual, in some cases, life insurance agents that will go down in the app, but to understand They understand the transaction, and they go out and foster relationships with those direct lenders, whether they be with the Wells Fargos or other lending institutions, and they team up with them. And so they are also there to be a resource and help those individuals that don't know anything about premium financing as well. Because once you've sold it, that doesn't mean that your job is over, because there has to be some sort of administration that needs to be going on in the background. And typically those intermediaries are very knowledgeable as to how that goes, how that reporting goes with respect to what information that lending institution is going to need in order to renew that loan the following year. So we require that the individuals who are going to be providing their clients with premium financing solutions use intermediaries, someone that we're comfortable with, that we vetted, and we understand that they understand how this business works, and quite frankly, have a good reputation, because there are some people out there that we found, because I've been in this business for over close to 20 years. Premium financing used to be big back in the day, but there was a lot of abusers of premium financing back in that day, and we don't want to fall prey to that again as an insurance company, and neither does any other insurance company. So we're pretty particular in terms of the lending institutions that we work with. So we'd be in a position to help your agents navigate that terrain so that they can feel comfortable knowing that they're working with individuals that know what they're doing and their clients are in good hands.
Wonderful. I appreciate all this that you've done with us today. I'm going to open everybody up a little bit here. So please, if you have some loud background noise, put yourself on mute yourself. But does anyone have any questions today for Matt that they want to ask? And sort of slowly opening everybody up here, so it will take me a few seconds. One person that's got a background noise there. Okay. I got most everybody open right now. Does anyone have any questions for Matt today on the subject we just went over? Someone just typed this in here. For business owner, could this be used as part of a tax-free retirement strategy?
So the question is, can the lending transaction be designed so as to provide the business owner with a tax-free retirement strategy, as I understand the question to be? And the answer to that is we don't see that a lot, but in the right situation, under the right circumstances, with the right design, it potentially could be.
Any more questions out there today? You want to type something up? Let me know. I can see a screen where everyone's typing up as well, Matt. Well, if no one else has any questions, or if you have questions, you know, you think of down the line, please feel free to give me a call. This is Kathy with Premier, Ask for a Life Marketer at 1-800-365-8208. And just ask for a life marketer. And Matt, if they have any questions for you, can they give you a call too?
Absolutely. They can give me a call at extension 3543.
Okay.
All right. And that's, I'll give you the full number, which is 802-229-3543. That's my direct line. Or they can reach me at email address mryan, R-Y-A-N, at nationallife.com.
Wonderful. Thanks, Matt. I appreciate your time, and thanks, everybody, for being on our Life Weekly with us. Next week, we will have another carrier out here. It looks like it's going to be Assurity. Mike Zendale from Assurity is going to be discussing some different options with us as well. So thanks a lot, everybody. Have a great day, and take care.
Thanks, Bye. Kathy. Bye-bye.
Thanks a lot, Matt. Bye.